handheld flashlight. David, tell us about the conditions down there.
Well, Jack, you can only imagine we're getting hit pretty hard. We're getting wind gusts up to 150 miles an hour. We are in the Wrightsville Beach, North Carolina, on Wilmington. We have wind gusts now up to about 120 miles an hour, so it's knocked the power out. It's knocking trees over. Some power lines have been flaring up along the way. Most of them are impassable, and it's pitch blackness, as you can see around me. So it is very dangerous for those who have chosen to remain behind, and not many have. There are mandatory evacuations in this area. Shelters are filling up, and the rain just keeps coming and coming. The worst of it is still yet to come, if you can believe it. Wind gusts could get as high as 125, maybe 130 miles an hour as this thing gets a little bit closer in between 9 and 9:30 Eastern time. The eye of the storm may pass a little bit to the west of here, but of course the northeast version is the most powerful section of the storm, and that's where we're beginning to feel the brunt of now. The storm surge, which can create all of that flooding, is a major problem here, but some of it in its early stages has already created enough flooding to create plenty of problems here. Jack?
All right, David Gregory, take care of yourself. David, we'll come back to you a little bit later for an update on how the conditions are.
I think some people may have been lulled into some sense of security by Bertha, and this one is a very, very difficult storm, different storm and difficult storm. And I don't know if you can hear the howling behind me, but it is really, really coming in right now.
All right, we can certainly hear it. And Jeff, we're going to ask you to stand by. We may be possibly coming back to you within the hour. CNN's Jeff Flock.
So we are probably on the weak. We are definitely on the weak side of the storm. If you can imagine, this is the weak side of the storm. Within the last hour or so, starting at about 7 o'clock, a little after seven, the winds did really pick up, and there are rocks on some of the roofs of these buildings, and they've been just flying off and smashing into the cars down here on the floor.
From Myrtle Beach, appreciate it.
CNN's Paul Caron was in Myrtle Beach earlier today. He's currently driving up the South Carolina coast. Right now he's moving north from Charleston, and he also joins us by telephone. Now, Paul, what are you encountering on your journey?
Lyndon, we were driving just a few moments ago along U.S. 17 just to the outskirts, about 10 miles from Myrtle Beach. We have experienced a few areas that have lost power. As John Zarella had said, a few areas near Georgetown were without power. But actually, just after that, a few areas still had power. So it's a bit inconsistent of some of the areas along the way that have lost power.
This is quite a system, a hurricane. Let's go ahead and show you the latest radar image. You can already see this ragged eye moving on shore right around Cape Fear area. The yellow and the orange indicate these strong bands of precipitation, and already inland in places like Duplin County, also in Sampson County, they've seen 4 to 6 inches of rainfall. We've already heard that roads right around the region and through Moorhead City, some of the roads there are impassable, and they're right on the fringe of the system. Now, it is moving to the north-northwest, so it continues to pull in this direction, and we think overnight it will continue in that northerly
continue
pattern.
To batter the South Carolina coast as well as North Carolina coast. We have correspondents continuing to check in, and we have another live picture for you from CNN's Charles Dewey. He is in Pawleys Island, South Carolina. Charles.
Natalie, here in Pawleys Island, specifically we're in Litchfield Island, the Litchfield part of the island, and the winds seem to be stronger now than they have been all evening. We have been experiencing 50 to 60 mile an hour winds as Fran made landfall up on the southeastern coast of North Carolina. We're about 50 airline miles from the site of landfall here at this location. And it seems like our winds are now gusting 60 to 75 miles an hour, right at the hurricane force threshold. A lot more debris has been flying around in the air here, although the power still is on in many areas. It has been knocked out to thousands of customers south of Myrtle Beach. Police just came by this location. Apparently, people got the idea that after the storm made landfall, that it was okay to get out and drive again. They thought that the danger was over. And there have been a number of accidents, and police are asking people to stay off the road by any stretch, not to take any chances of getting out on the roads. They say it's still very dangerous. There are a lot of trees down. As you can see, the wind is still blowing very, very strongly here, and it's expected to continue that way for several hours. It comes in lulls. We get a brief respite, then the rain and the wind come back.
Really, hang on there. Thanks so much for that report from Pawleys Island, South Carolina.
This is what the hurricane looks like and sounds like in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Remember, this is just a little bit south, just a tad south of where the eye of the hurricane has moved in. Now, there's been a lot of rain there, and more rain is expected. Now, let me take you up the beach, if you will, move north to Wilmington, North Carolina. Try to show you the picture from Wilmington, North Carolina here in a moment. You can see the hurricane's eye. The picture got knocked down. This is live television. That's the way it goes, and you cover with live television something as strange as a hurricane. If you want to look on your map, you find Wilmington, North Carolina, and then go just a little bit north of that, up to Wrightsville Beach, all the way up to, say, Camp Lejeune, North Carolina, the big Marine base there. And there you can pinpoint just almost precisely where the eye it has been coming in for the last, hour and a half.
Coming up on a special edition of WeatherScope, the latest on Hurricane Fran, right after your local forecast.
We're going to try to go back to Jill Brown here momentarily. I believe we can right now. Jill is now live again in the eye of Hurricane Fran. Jill, we talked to you about 10 minutes ago. What is the latest right now? Are the winds still calm, or have you been hit by the other side?
No, Mike and John, it's still nice and calm here. We're in Bolivia in Brunswick County. Now, we're at the Emergency Operations Center for the county, and I wanted to show you our setup here, because again, we were on the south side, right out here a few minutes ago. I'm in the garage now, and this is the north side. These garage doors in here, they're saying, will withstand about 120 mile per hour wind.
And Doppler radar estimates right now are showing up to a foot of rainfall so far, and even if that's overdone by 20%, we're still talking about 10 inches of rain. The ground is saturated, and we're showing Jill right now, the viewers at home, the radar, and with all this wet ground, that is just, boy, that is a perfect prescription with strong winds to get trees. Okay, Jill, for safety reasons, we don't want to put you and the crew in harm's way. We want to get you a chance to move your crew and move yourself. We're going to take a brief break, so stay with us for continuing coverage on Fran. We'll take a break, check your local forecast so you can make your weekend plans, and then we'll be right back.